So, penceramah kita pada hari ini, dia memilih topik yang agak asing untuk dirungkaikan bersama, iaitu FM, The Abandoned Technique. Umum mengetahui bahawa dalam bidang fisioterapi ini terdapat pelbagai teknik yang digunakan untuk merawat para pesakit. Namun, apakah teknik yang diabaikan ini? Kita akan memperoleh jawapannya sebentar lagi. Sebelum kata bersulam bicara, sebelum ilmu menusuk di dada. Kata orang, tak kenal maka tak cinta. Maka dengan ini, izinkan saya untuk memperkenalkan dan mengucapkan Assalamualaikum dan selamat datang buat Encik Muhammad Rizal Ibrahim, selaku pengarah dan pemilik Urehat Sendirian Berhad. Sihat ya Encik Rizal? Encik Rizal sihat?
Baru unmute mikrofon. Alhamdulillah sihat. Alhamdulillah,
okey. Untuk pengetahuan para hadirin, Urehat menawarkan program rehabilitasi dan fisioterapi di pusat rawatan yang terletak di Bandar Seri Putra Kajang dan juga perkhidmatan rawatan di rumah sekitar Lembah Kelang. Beliau juga mempunyai 18 tahun pengalaman bekerja sebagai seorang pegawai jurupulih anggota badan dalam pelbagai organisasi. Jadi tanpa membuang masa, saya terus menjemput Encik Muhammad Rizal bagi menjawab persoalan kita pada hari ini dengan tajuk beliau FM, The Abandoned Technique. Silakan Encik Rizal.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Rabbi surahdi sadri wa yassirli amri wahlun uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala sayyidina Muhammad. Selamat pagi, assalamualaikum kepada semua. Terima kasih kepada cik moderator kita, Cik Puan Fatihah Ubaidah. Semua bayi biru-biru pitas, Cik Zahidah yang tak serik-serik ganggu saya. Saya ingat lebih kurang dekat 2 bulan. Dan every time dia kacau, saya tengah sibuk kerja ataupun saya tengah drive nak pergi rumah klien. Tahniah saya ucapkan, sebab even malam tadi pun kita ada buat rehearsal because I'm not too familiar with this platform. So dia sanggup luangkan masa dan I think you all do a very great job. Yeah. Pada Presiden juga, Sarah, walaupun dia tak kacau saya, maybe I think you are great leader. You segregate all the apa task ni to your ni kan. You punya EJKN Biro. And then sampai semalam saya dipahamkan student-student daripada apa nama universiti daripada seberang ya, universiti. Saya macam tak ada terdengar suara Prof Haidee ya. Betul kan? Okay, assalamualaikum juga kepada sahabat-sahabat saya, rakan-rakan sejuangan. Saya nampak kat sini Cik Puan Ida Hasni. Tadi saya nampak ada Cik Yusri. Okey. Sebelum saya nak teruskan, saya dipahamkan platform ni lain macam sikit. Dia tak boleh nak interaction. So last night saya dah pass my slide to Zahidah. So kita akan buat lain sikit hari ni. Kita nak buat macam biar dia yang present. So dalam masa tu saya boleh nampak, still saya able to see all your comments apa semua kan. Okay, so sebab saya suka kalau kita lebih two-way communication daripada kalau saya just deliver, saya pun tak nampak buku saya sendiri, saya tak nampak your reaction, nanti saya tak tahu kan. Okay, so just sesantai-santai, and hopefully at the end of the day, kalau tak banyak pun, little bit knowledge you akan dapat lah. Okay, I think kita boleh start lah. Siapa yang will present the slide on behalf of us? Okay. What is FM? Okay, FM ataupun nama lain dia, all the short form DFM atau DTFM, and DTM is the same short form. Okay, saya nak tengok from the chat siapa yang rasa-rasa ada idea apa FM ni. Okay, tengok cepat. Sekarang ni ada start 53 people saya rasa. Any idea what is FM ataupun DFM, DTFM? Facial manipulation, okay good. Deep transversal massage, good. Sarah Zulaika. Lagi? Nah, Sarah Zulaika ni agaknya malam tadi bila dia dah nampak saya punya slide, dia dah dapat dia baca and then dia Google kan. Okay, bagus. Ada ke alumni yang bukan student kat sini? Ataupun ada ke memang betul daripada seberang? Yang lain ni macam mana ni? Tak ada interaction pun? Saya ada lebih kurang kat 80 slide eh. So saya tak tahu kata-kata tidak. Betul eh, 80 slide lah saya dah. 80-20 lah kan. Sikit je. So banyak-banyak santai. Tapi dalam slide saya agak full of so my intention is at the end of the day, you boleh jadikan benda tu nota lah. Yeah, you boleh print out dan you akan boleh jadikan dia nota. Okay. So, yeah, Sarah Zulaika betul. Basically, SFM is friction massage ataupun deep friction massage ataupun deep transverse friction massage ataupun ada yang panggil deep friction, deep transverse massage. Okay, next. Okay, nak tahu macam mana teknik dia semua? Okay, ada tak yang dah belajar? I don't know. Either this technique is already diajar dalam one of your syllabus. Ada ya, ada. Ada tak? Come on guys, interaction dengan saya. Saya tengah baca you punya apa nama chatbox ni. Nyalah, angguk-angguk saya tak nampak salah. Saya limited, tak boleh nampak semua orang. Ada se, okay. Okay. So, sebelum saya teruskan, saya rasa ramai yang audience kat sini, handphone memang ada sebelah tangan kan. So, boleh tak saya nak minta you all pergi ke Facebook dan like you rehab. Kalau saya tak dapat lebih kurang 10 likes, saya tak nak teruskan. Acik tak? Acik ya?
Acik Rizam, dapat gula-gula ke kalau like tu?
Tak, like itu kan gratis.
Boleh Encik Rizam.
Dah like.
Okay, good. Ah, siapa masuk chatbot Sarah, chatbot Sarah cakap nak belanja gula-gula. Okay. Saya present dalam English saja, so kita dalam English dan dalam BM dan kita santai-santai saja. Anytime kalau ada yang you tak clear ataupun tak sure, you boleh unmute your mic and then tanya ataupun you boleh drop your question in the chatbot. So, it's up to me lah nak jawab ke tidak. Okay. Okay, I think bila kita boleh go to the next slide. Okay, friction massage overview. Friction massage, deep friction massage, deep transverse friction massage, deep transverse massage. It depends lah on how you want to pronounce it. Basically, it's the same technique. And then specifically connective tissue massage that was developed by Cyrex. Siapa Cyrex? Cyrex basically nama dia is James Cyrex. Dia adalah British physician ataupun lebih dikenali sebagai father of orthopedic medicine. Selain daripada dia develop this transverse friction massage technique, dia juga is well known dengan minimal manipulation lah. Minimal manipulation dengan ada satu lagi because he's a physician, so dia juga sangat pakar dalam injection, yeah? Injection pada sendi-sendi sama ada untuk bursitis ataupun tendinitis. Yeah? Okay, dia dah meninggal pada tahun 1985 dan most of the techniques is delivered dan setiap kali di upgrade oleh satu kumpulan fisioterapi yang dipanggil EDGOM ataupun apa tu, European Teaching Group of Orthopedic Medicine, yeah, yang berpusat di HQ di Belgium. Okey, apakah kita masuk balik pada friction massage? Jadi apakah the purpose you nak buat friction massage ni? Actually is to maintain the mobility with the soft tissue structures of ligament, tendon and muscle and eventually to preventing adhesion scar forming. Okay. Macam mana kita nak buat friction massage? The massage is deep and must be applied transversely to the specific tissue involved. Yeah. Kenapa saya katakan tajuk saya, saya tak mengatakan itu satu fakta ya, FM the abandoned technique. Ya, sebab tu saya letakkan question mark kat belakang. Because that's why saya tanya, adakah yang alumni so sudah bekerja? Ya. Umum mengetahui even selepas 18 tahun saya bekerja, kalau kita dalam setting hospital, masa itu sangat-sangat crucial kan. So untuk nak buat manual teknik ni, actually you kena one on one, and then selalunya manual teknik yang sangat famous biasanya kalau kita akan buat joint mop kan, kalau kita nak massage pun ala kadar saja. Dan bila kita buat massage ni macam alamak nak buat massage dia kan, macam alamak kan. Memang even that is a normal stigma pada semua kita kan. Even kalau orang kata physio, massage boleh dan terus kita nak tarik muka, betul tak kan? Tapi this is basically bukannya massage yang macam biasa tu kan, because we are doing it localized and specific to the area, dan itulah yang tempat kita nak buat supaya there is some effect ada kat situ. Okay. Macam selain daripada tu, kita tahu what are the technique of the massage, macam needling kan, effarage, dan mereka kita pun sendiri kita tahu kan for the specific massage technique adalah khas untuk specific punya problem. So basically friction massage ni dia bukan saja boleh, I think kita dah boleh ke next slide. Okay. Dia sebenarnya apabila kita buat friction massage ni, dia ada three main effect lah. Okay, in fact there is a three combination effect. First is traumatic hyperemia. Okay, this will be helpful to evacuate some metabolic, example Lewis substance P, in order to avoid a too high concentration, possibly irritating pre-nerve ending, assist removal of chemical irritants, then allow the transportation of agonious opiates, and finally dia boleh bagikan kita pain relief. This is Lewis substance P ni, I tak tahu you ada belajar tak, maybe ada belajar kan. So this through the vasodilatation of the vein. So bila kita buat dengan betul friction massage ni, first effect kita akan dapat is traumatic hyperemia, and then the second effect yang kita akan dapat is a movement of the affected structures. Basically the movement of the affected structures is the most important effect, since in acute and subacute lesion we aim to avoid the formation of adhesion, and in chronic stage we would like to remodel the scar tissue in an optimal way. So bila keadaan tu, injury tu baru berlaku, kenapa kita nak buat ni? Sebab kita nakkan tiadanya formation of adhesion, dan kalau sakit itu atau masalah itu dalam keadaan yang kronik, so kita nak remodel balik the scar of the tissue in optimal way. And the last effect is to stimulate the mechanoreceptor, so resulting in a temporary anesthetic effect from this technique can last up to 24 hours. So it basically is quite interesting. Kalau you all pernah try dengan teknik yang betul, dengan cara yang betul, dengan duration yang betul, then ini based, I talk with my base experience. Bila kalau you dah palpate kawasan tu, and then you rasa okay, then you tahu that the issue, the problem ada berada kat situ, selepas you buat all the special tests, all the detail antara physical examination, ya, you tekan dekat kawasan tu, of course mula-mula sakit akan rasa sakit. Akan rasa sakit dan you tahu inilah ni kan tempatnya, dan you dah start buat friction massage. You buat friction massage 2-3 kali dekat kawasan tu dan pressure akan rasa sakit. Dan jangan takut, jangan alamak pressure sakit. Sakitlah pressure kan, lari lah, tak nak buat lah, ataupun buat sebenarnya tak apa, dia tak ais kan. You just keep doing, you try, you buat lagi sambil tu kan. You kira lah berapa kali friction tu kan, let's say dalam 50 kali, then you tanya balik, sakit lagi ke? Then you akan start cakap, hey, sakit dah kurang. Lepas tu you start lagi buat, you continue buat, then you count lah kan. Kalau you just count dalam 100 kali you friction, then you tanya sakit lagi, kurang daripada tadi lah. See, then kalau you buat betul this technique, you punya client, you punya patient akan cakap, eh, you ada macam magic hand lah. Basically, it's just a simple technique. Yeah. Okay, so why? Because of these three effect yang ada kat situ. Yeah. Okay, next. Jangan malu-malu kalau ada soalan ni. In between, saya still baca juga. Because sikit je ni, I think tak sampai satu jam pun kita dah boleh habis this slide. Okay, indication and contraindication. Indication, FM is performed on muscular, tendinous and ligamentous lesion. Okay, so tahu tak sebelum ni, massage tu bukan hanya pada muscle saja. So, in deep friction massage, kita boleh perform dekat muscular, tendon and impact on the ligament itself. Okay, so ada, of course, setiap teknik ada contraindication dia, and then some of the indication is calcification or ossification, rheumatoid tendinous lesion, local sepsis, skin problem ataupun skin disease such as blister, ulcer ataupun psoriasis, bursitis, periostesis, disorder of nervous structure and then large hematoma. Okay, so clear so far, clear ke? Jangan beku sangat. Yeah, it's very simple. Yeah. Okay, thank you Sarah. Okay, next. Okay, good, clear. Okay, technical aspect. Okay, memang dia deep friction massage, memang is a massage, tapi untuk dapatkan result dengan outcome yang betul, FM can only have a positive effect if the procedure is performed correctly. Therefore, it is very important to respect some practical rules. Okay, basically dalam technical aspect of deep friction massage ni, dia ada 7. So kita go one by one. Nah, nombor 1 is exact localization. You need to perform friction massage to the point, example to the correct spot defined after careful functional examination. So kalau you dah tahu frozen shoulder, you dapat satu case frozen shoulder. So you nak friction massage dekat mana, agak-agak kan, because you know ada apa, rotator cuff muscle pun ada 4. So which one yang ada problem, which one yang ada apa ni, inflammation ataupun mana yang ketat, mana yang tengah spasm. Kalau you dah dapat detect, oh, I think lepas you punya skillful examination, lepas you gunakan whatever you punya skill untuk define apa problem tu, and then you tahu this is supraspinatus. So dekat mana you nak palpate? Takkan you nak palpate all the way, takkan you perform this technique all the way daripada dia punya origin go sampai dekat ni attachment of the supraspinatus. Tidak kan? So dia sebenarnya dia ada teknik-teknik dia. So you buat find the correct spot and then you start your technique kat sana. Okay, that is the first rules, technical aspect. Then the second one is don't glide over the skin. Okay, bila you nak buat, make sure you friction the structure at fault and you don't glide over the skin. If the skin of the patient is quite slippery, sekejap saya tutup lah. Because example the application of some ointment, ya, sebelum dia nak datang kat awak, dia dah sapu apa nama, minyak ke, dia sapu lotion ke kan, so tempat tu dah jadi slippery, then the best solution is to clear the area with an alcohol swab or to use a thin layer of cotton wool between finger and skin in order to avoid gliding over the skin. So make sure you clearkan dulu supaya tak adalah slippery masa you nak jalankan teknik tu tadi. Then don't glide over the skin. Kalau you boleh tengok apa saya tunjuk, so jangan buat macam tu lah, don't glide. So basically you kena, kalau you dah dapat satu tempat tu, you kena tolak dulu the reserve skin tu ke tepi, dan you find the tissue ataupun the tendon whatsoever yang you nak palpate tu, yang you nak lakukan prosedur, then baru you jalankan you punya pergerakan ataupun prosedur. So bukannya sini ya, okay, then buat, no. So you kena tolak dulu, basically you tolak dulu the superficial skin tu ke tepi, dan baru you dapat the good grip of that area yang you nak buat teknik. Okay, then we go to the next technical aspect. Okay, technical aspect yang ketiga is a transverse. So it's our purpose to mobilize the fibers by doing friction massage in some situation followed by slight repetitive longitudinal stretch. Okay, you bila you nak buat this technique tu, dah lama dia pun dah transverse kan. So kalau the structures of the electrical structures tu dia macam ni longitudinal, then you kena buat transverse lah. You tak boleh lah kalau you nak buat dekat let's say dekat bicep tendon, you buat macam tu kan. So itu you just tak tahulah cara urut apa, tapi kalau nak perform transverse friction massage, you punya go cross the structure. Okay, and then next, sufficient amplitude. Mobilize the structure at fault intensively using a sufficient range of movement, using a big movement, arm movement instead of just finger movement, while facilitate the execution of the technique. Taking reserves of the skin, moving the skin superficially in the opposite direction before applying the friction pressure which facilitate the procedure. Okay, nak buat selalu yang saya perhatikan kalau orang buat, orang tahu, tapi macam sakit kan, okay, no. Basically, you kena buat the whole arm movement macam tu. So, kenapa? Nanti saya akan explain. Dia bukannya macam ni je, nampak tak? Nah, dia bukan macam tu, dia basically dia kena buat the whole arm movement. And I will explain it later why. Okay, and then sufficient depth. Depending on the localization of the structure, FM has to be performed deeper or not. We just need sufficient depth of an optimal mobilization of the fibers. This is quite subjective. So macam mana nak tahukan sufficient depth tu kan? So basically it depend on the patient lah. Kalau you dapat abang-abang handsome ataupun awet-awet cun, then you buatlah so-so kan. Tapi kalau you dapat yang patient yang agak fasi, and then you tekan lah. Betul? Tidak, bukan. Joke aside lah. Okay, so you tengok kawasan mana. Kalau it's very deep, and then you give a good firm pressure sikit, and then kalau it's very bony prominent ataupun dekat dengan bone, you bagilah just nice punya pressure, sufficient depth. At least you dapat rasa apa yang you nak friction, and then bila you friction tu, you dapat rasa dan macam lampi lah ketam. Okay, so far so good, clear? Laju sangat
ni? Yeah.
Okay, good.
Clear.
Okay, next. Okay, starting position. Make sure that you as well as the patient are in comfortable position to perform the technique. Okay, first, of course, mana-mana teknik pun kita kena carilah kita punya comfortable position, and then juga patient punya comfortable position. And then the key point is ligament and tendons are put slightly on the stretch to friction, but muscle belly lesion are flexion from a relaxed position without longitudinal tension. So ada sedikit perbezaan. Kalau you mean untuk nak friction the ligament and tendon, so you kena position that ligament and tendon on the slight stretch punya position. Ataupun kalau you nak doing the procedure on the muscle belly, so you letaklah muscle belly tu dalam keadaan yang position yang dia relax. Okay. And then the next technical aspect is save energy. Mostly use an active phase, pressure follows by a relaxation phase, no pressure. So dalam this technique, dia ada dua phase. Satu which is active phase yang you give a pressure, dan satu lagi yang tidak. Dan kebiasaannya bila you nak bagi on the active phase is mostly towards to you. Bila you nak tekan. Dia bukannya bila you dapat, you tekan kiri kanan, you tekan. Tidak, dia ada skill, dia ada cara dia. So you give pressure bawa ke you, and then when you go towards menjauhi you, you release, and then you tekan balik, and then you relax, and then you tekan balik, and then you relax. Okay, why using? Because using constant pressure could be very uncomfortable for both patient and therapist. Exceptional for friction of the MTJ, muscular tendon junction, or suppress matters on the interest side, because in this technique dia ada special case sikit, because dia ada two phase. You boleh buat dua-dua in dalam keadaan active phase. Tapi most of the technique selalunya memang ada active phase, memang ada relaxation phase. And then focus on bigger arm movement instead of smaller finger movement. The latter are much more tiring for the therapist and painful for the patient. Keep your fingers joint slightly flexed. Okay, kenapa kita nak buat tu, kita bukan hanya buat dengan jari saja, pergerakan jari saja, tapi kita kena buat on the bigger movement, disebabkan first of all, memang kalau you just concentrate on the jari saja, of course sekejap saja you akan rasa penat. Okay, so berapa lama nak kena buat ni? Kan dia kadang-kadang sampai 20 minutes ya. Silap-silap awak kalau buat dalam masa 2 minit pun jari awak dah cramp. So then kalau you just do the motion on your finger alone, then of course dia akan menyakitkan you, the client ataupun the patient. So that's why dia kena buat on the bigger movement. So it save energy for you and then to avoid excessive pain to the patient. Okay, boleh kita proceed to the next slide. Okay, duration and frequency. Most lesion kan, 3 kali seminggu is a good frequency, mostly 15 minutes per session, starting with the first session of 10 minutes. Busan kan? Busan kan? 10 minit busan kan? Oh, Sarah, oh busan. 10 minit nak duduk buat dia. That's why I think saya jarang nampak benda ni clinician buat. Unless kalau maybe dia dalam betul-betul setup yang one on one, you boleh nampak. Tapi again, I emphasize this technique based on my experience and based on the other clinician experience, is the outcome of the result is very significant in terms of improving the pain and the mobility of the patient punya problem. Okay, chronic lesion is about 20 minutes and average of 2 session per week combined with longitudinal stretch exercise. Okay, tadi kalau you ada catch dalam ada few previous slide tu, dia ada cakap ada saya beritahu dia ada sometimes dia kena combine dengan longitudinal stretch exercise. So this is mostly for chronic lesion. So kalau you dah buat and then you buat, you perform longitudinal stretch and then you continue balik you punya technique. Okay, in certain acute cases, apply in progressive way, 5 session per week, gradually building up until 15 minutes of friction massage at the end of the first week. Second week, then you boleh kurangkan kepada session tu pada 3 kali seminggu. Okay, in some problem, sometimes you need to friction 2 localization within the same structure. Example, medial and lateral part plus together with anteromedial parts of the Achilles tendon. So Achilles tendon panjang kan, kalau ada Achilles tendinopathy atau Achilles tendinitis atau tendon Achilles, whatever you name it, so you boleh, you kena buat, let's say this is your punya Achilles tendon, you boleh buat dekat belah sini and you boleh buat dekat belah sini juga, because benda tu panjang. Okay, and then the other key point is if the structure is too tender, and then the interval between session tu jarakkanlah sikit. Tapi biasanya either is a subacute, either is acute, ataupun either is a chronic lesion, bila you buat, you tak perlu buat lah pun. Kalau betul-betul you tak ada masa, tak payahlah buat sampai 20 minit. Even you buat dalam 5 minit pun benda tu dah ada effect dia. This is from apa yang saya cakap berdasarkan pengalaman lah. Okay, next. Normal execution. Bila kita bercakap pasal deep friction massage ni, orang selalu sebut buat dengan normal execution, buat dengan normal execution. So wrap up apa tu normal execution? Is normal execution is one or more finger are put onto the lesion, reinforced by one or more fingers. A reserve of skin is taking in the opposite direction. Pressure is applied at the active phase of friction massage with movement toward ourselves. In most cases, this is large arm movement and not a small finger movement, with all your finger joints slightly flat. And then the relaxation followed by the relaxation phase into the opposite direction. Ini yang saya tak explain tadi. So basically a normal exhibition, inilah dia maksudnya. And then sometimes all fingers are used next to each other while you perform this technique. Example, when treating muscle belly lesion in large muscle. This is necessary to prevent the formation of addition. When FM is given tenoperiosteally, they should be in contact with both tendon and bone. Okay, clear tak? Faham tak? Ada nak saya explain more on this slide?
Tak faham, Encik Rizal.
Mana yang tak faham tu, Cik Puan Fatihah Ubaidah?
Wah, Fatihah Ubaidah eh. Fatihah pun okay kot, Cik Rizal. yang apa, yang first paragraph tu kan, saya macam tak dapat nak bayang macam mana nak kena apa. A reserve is taken in the opposite direction, saya tak boleh nak bayang macam mana.
Dia macam ni Fatihah nak buat ramai ha. Mudah lah. Okay, yang mana? Okay. Saya explain, tapi jangan risau. At the end of the slide, ada dua video yang menunjukkan teknik ni. Okay. So, okay. Saya explain sambil saya tunjuk. Okay. Say one or more fingers are put. Biasanya kita akan pakai dua fingers. Jarang-jarang sekali kita pakai thumb. Kalau kita pakai thumb pun, kita pakai yang ujung kat sini ni. Yeah. And then of course lah, sebelum you nak buat tu, make sure lah you cut your nails. Yeah. So reinforced by one or more finger, a reserve of skin is taken opposite direction. Okay, macam saya cakap tadi, bila you rasa you dapat kat sini lah, saya ni senang saya nak tunjuk kan. Okay, sini senang lah saya nak tunjuk. Okay, tempat lain nanti susah saya nak tunjuk kan, nak buka baju semua juga kan. Okay, so let's say ni ada skin. Kalau you rasa you nak palpate this area lah, imagine this is you punya supraspinatus ataupun you punya whatever lah kan. So you kena, okay, kita dekat mana tadi, a reserve of skin is taken to the opposite direction. So you tolak dulu residual skin ni, reserve skin ni, tolak. Nampak tak? You tolak dulu dia. You jangan you nak palpate, you nak buat kat sini, you tekan and then you buat. No, you dapatnya okay, you ambil, you tolak dulu. So supaya benda yang atas ni, kulit ni tak mengganggu. Dan bukannya kita tak nak friction this kulit, kita nak friction structure yang kat bawah tu. Yeah? Okay, clear so far? Okay, your skin taken to position. Pressure is applied at the active phase. Okay, pressure bila you dah tolak, then you nak buat active phase ni. So you tekan, this is when you give the pressure. Okay, on FM with movement towards of size. Kan tadi saya cakap bila dia ada active phase, dia ada relax phase. So dah tu, you tekan tu, dia bawa macam ni. Nampak? You tekan. Okay. Okay. In ni saya cakap tu, in a large arm movement tu. Okay. So jadi bukannya dia tekan, bukan macam ni eh. Bukannya nampak beza dia ni dengan ni. Kalau you buat ni, sakit. Patient akan sakit dan you pun akan cepat letih. Sekejap lagi, krem jari aku, krem. So that's why the movement daripada tangan apa. Okay. The movement and not the small finger movement with the, okay, then joint pun awak ni pun kena slack lah. Kalau you buat macam ni, sakit, okay, and then dia kena dekat you punya kuku kan. Okay, so go macam tu. And then the relaxation phase then follow into the opposite direction. So bila you dapat active phase, you bagi pressure, you go. And then ni, you nak tolak balik, tak payah bagi pressure. Pergi balik and then go. Tekan, relax. Tekan, relax. Clear, Fatihah?
Clear, Encik Izzah. Terima kasih.
Okay.
Nanti kita post kasam.
Post apa? Post kasam? Wah, sempat lah buat ni.
Kasam.
Okay, next. Okay. So, kita dah tahu dia teknik. Then, bila masa kita nak integrate this, apa nama teknik ni? So, bila kita nak integrate, kita nak gunakan teknik ni, kita kena tahu what is the principal technique of soft tissue lesion. Yeah. Okay, so kita masuk sikit. Teknik dah habis eh? Teknik dah habis, the introduction ataupun whatever point based on teknik tadi dah habis. So sekarang ni kita nak masuk kepada prinsip of treatment yang berkaitan dengan soft tissue lesion. Okay, soft tissue lesion benefit at all time for movement. Absolute rest is not to be recommended, although in some acute case relative rest avoidance of certain movement is necessary. Okay, kita selalu belajar pasal rest ya. So rest kan, kita satu rest. So kalau totally rest tu basically dia tak bagus ya. Bukan, dia just kejap dia juga rest, tapi bila tu you kena juga buat as simple as you kena bergegak untuk bagi pumping action muscle tu kan, supaya tak dia swelling tu bergerak kan. Kalau you just in case, of course lah kalau patah you kena lah immobilize kan, kena lah letak sini ke punya, tapi kalau sini patah sini pun jari-jari pun kena gerak je kan. So ini yang dia cakap, yeah, soft tissue lesion is benefit at all time for movement, so you kena move. So macam mana nak move? Kena nak kena gerak ke? No, that's why you buat friction massage. Bila you buat friction massage, that faulty area tu yang ada masalah tu bergerak. Faham tak? Nampak tak dia memang set? Okay, next, sealing without sufficient movement at the site of the lesion leads to the formation of adhesion either during the repair and the remodeling phase, resulting in an adhesive, less functional scar formation and the start of a chronic lesion. Yeah, kalau you healing naturally memang akan ada masalah kan, kita semua tahu kan, kalau dia just biar saja tak bergerak apa semua, and then banyaklah secondary complication akan berlaku. So contohnya masa repair and remodeling phase tu akan ada adhesion, ada scar yang ketat dan macam-macam lagi lah, dan eventually dia akan limit dia punya julat pergerakan, range of motion kan. The most traumatic inflammatory reaction can also limit the mobility at the site of the lesion. Thus, we should apply it as much as possible by applying FM. Okay, chronic lesion are mostly result of absence of treatment at the beginning or poor non-functional treatment. It is advisable to treat even minor lesion as soon as possible in order to have a healing with optimal scar formation. Okay, ini some of the principle of treatment, and then next. Okay, in acute lesion, we have to avoid at all time that adhesion interfere with the scar formation, and in case of chronic lesion, we try to re-trigger the healing mechanism so that the repair and remodeling phase can happen in optimal circumstance, leading to a better alignment of fibers and tensile strength, and try to maintain normal connective tissue mobility. Faham kot, ha? Faham ya? Okay, kalau faham next, dah 9.42 ya. Okay, so bila kita nak apply? Sebenarnya macam yang dalam the first study pun saya dah cakap, dia boleh apply dalam mana-mana masa pun, either is acute stage chronic, ataupun chronic stage. Okay, so minor muscular tear during acute stage, ini some of the principle yang you boleh guna pakai lah kalau you nak buat FM. So FM, give with the muscles in relaxed position followed by unloaded active ataupun electrical contraction. You nak start lepas you buat FM tu, you nak start bagi whatever tense ke IT ke, is up to you. And then relative rest, avoid certain movement. And then kalau minor muscular tear in chronic stage, you boleh buat FM and then active and electrical contraction. Lepas tu remember, kalau dalam chronic, you kena buat combine dengan longitudinal stretch and then prescribe patient with home stretching exercise. Okay, ini dalam minor muscular tear. Next, minor ligamentous sprain, acute lesion. Okay, acute lesion, progressive. You bila ada dalam acute lesion, kalau ligament sprain ni, maksud dia progressive, you nak buat friction massage ni, maksud dia kan tadi at the end of the session tu you boleh buat sampai 20 minit kan, tapi tak perlu. Kalau first tu you just bagi macam teaser je dalam 2 minit, 5 minit je. Lepas tu barulah next session tu you gradually increase the duration. And then you boleh combine dengan active unloaded mobilization dan rest. Synchronic lesion dibuat, buat dia follow the step. Kalau you rasa 10 minit ataupun you nak terus ke 20 minit pun boleh. If necessary, do manipulation to release adhesion. Manipulation. Active mobilization and then combine with proprioception movement ataupun proprioception exercise. Okay, mobilization is better than immobilization. In case of acute lesion in the foot and the knee, we cannot give a full portion of facial massage as from the first treatment. Progressive using with the, so you kena buat dengan using progressive strategy. Ini yang saya explain tadi. Ya, bila you dapat ni, you kena buat acute lesion ke dalam ligamentous sprain ni, you tak boleh terus buat dalam masa 10 minit. Usually you buat slow-slow. First session 5 minit and then you tambah 7 minit and 8 minit then up to 15 minutes. Okay, next.
Kiranya tak mau bagi dia punya ligament muscle tu terkejut kau macam tu, Encik Rizam?
Sort of sebab sometimes dia ada juga after effect dia, dia sakit. And then dalam acute lesion dia tahulah tengah dalam bengkak kan, ada hematoma ataupun ada swelling, ada keradangan berlaku kat situ, inflammation, panas semua kan. So bila dalam keadaan tu, that's why tadi dia kata superficial depth. Sufficient depth. Maknanya you jangan bila tengah bengkak tu, sebenarnya dia tengah bengkak apa, you boleh buat tau, you boleh buat. Tapi buka, janganlah tekan betul-betul. Dan janganlah duduk pergi tekan kat situ lagi bertambah pun bengkak lah kan. Memang kita tahap yang kita belajar kan, kalau jet jangan massage, kalau massage dia lagi besar kan. Tapi sebenarnya you boleh buat. Basically you stimulate that area. You buat, you stimulate that area, tapi jangan duduk tekan kuat-kuat. And then bila you buat duduk lama-lama, so kemungkinan akan jadi contraindication balik nanti, sebab dia you menambahkan injury kat kawasan tu. Clear? Okay, next.
Clear.
Okay, habis dah, ada apa-apa pertanyaan? Siapa yang jaga ni? Jangan ni lagi. Tadi tu ada video. Siapa yang ni? Sarah ya?
Video orang lain akan presentkan.
Oh, okey. Mana boleh macam tu?
Tak ada problem audio sikit. Jadi kita alih ke orang lain untuk presentkan.
Okey, nanti slide last dia tu tak jumpa lah, tak nampak lah. Kan, lepas tu ada slide last lah. Tak kacik tu. Okey, kita tengok video lah. Pull sekejap video ni. Okey, video ni dipresent oleh Stephen O'Connor. Dia adalah presiden Edgom yang saya cakap tadi. Edgom yang ajar pasal diffusion massage dengan Syrah manipulation teknik. So saya berguru dengan dia jugalah. So masa dalam video ni you kena tengok apa, basically is a wrap up of apa yang saya explain tadi. Okay, silakan. Suara tak dengar ni. Ada problem ke?
Present slide ke present screen?
Tak dengar yang tadi. Ya kan?
Present slide bukan present screen.
Oh, Encik Rizal nak buat suara latar belakang.
Saya tak biasa buat suara latar belakang. Kalau TikTok boleh lah, kita try lah.
TikTok selalunya Zahidah dia pandai buat lah, dia selalu buat TikTok.
Nanti bagi ID ya. Tidak lagi juga saya install apps TikTok.
Kita buat collab lah Encik Rizam, Fitas X Urihat. Macam tu, boleh?
Boleh, tak ada masalah. I is okay.
Dengar ke?
So, how can we fix the spinalis? Well, there are different options. In fact, there are two options. You can friction the muscular tendons junction, but the lesion over there is very rare. So in the majority of the cases, the lesion lies at the tenopericostal junction. So how can we reach that localization? First, we ask the patient to move the shoulder in medial rotation. And what is the purpose? The purpose is that a tuberculum meatus comes in front of the acromion, and like this, it's easier for us to palpate the structure. How you palpate the supraspinatus, that's your own choice, as long as you reach it. But one interesting method would be following. We palpate on the spine of the scapula, and we palpate in a lateral direction. What do we feel? We just feel dome. We continue in lateral direction until we lose contact with the bone, and then we feel something soft again. We go back to the bone, and from that point, we palpate in an anterior direction. Automatically, we are on the acromion. At a certain moment, you will lose contact with the acromion. You fall off the acromion, and you fall on the tuberculum mind. That's the place to be. That's the place where we have a supraspinatus tenoperioscal lesion. Okay, how are we going to friction? Well, make sure the patient is in a good position, and make sure that you as a therapist, you are in good position. We need this kind of grip. We call it the C grip. You take a contact on the structure. You take a low fulcrum with the thumb. And the first thing we do is we move the skin superficially in an opposite direction. We call that the reserved skin. Then we exert pressure. And the active phase of a deep friction goes in that direction. Make sure you have a nice big and not a movement like this. This is very tiring for us, and it's also more painful for the patient, so that's not the purpose. So always try to save energy by doing nice, big movements. And another little detail, you don't use constant pressure. If you use constant pressure, again, it's very tiring, but it's also painful for the patient. So with a good friction massage, we always use pressure, active phase, no pressure, pressure, no pressure. And why did we take this reserve of skin? Why did we push the skin superficially in the opposite direction first? Well, to allow us to have a big without too much tension in the skin. Strangely enough, many people around the world keep on doing the same mistakes. I see very often that people friction the supraspinatus not from this position, but rather from that position, and they do something like this. Well, this is not a friction of supraspinatus. This is a friction of the anterior border of the abdomen. So it's very, very important that your thumb is always in a low position, that your fingernail points towards the ceiling, that you have a pressure in downward direction, and then you are on the supraspinatus. Another mistake I regularly see is that they friction just like this. But that's also a friction of acromion, and not a friction of supraspinatus. So please try to avoid that. The golden rule is this position. So when we friction the supraspinatus, then of course we need to be sure that the lesion is at that specific localization. Therefore, clinical reasoning and diagnostic specificity is quite important. In that perspective, I refer to the EDGOM publications and the EDGOM courses.
Video lagi satu.
Ada video satu lagi. Yes.
Nampak ke?
Nampak.
Position is 90 degrees elbow flexion and supination. We palpate the lateral aspect of the lateral epicondyle, We put our thumb a little bit higher until we reach the sharp edge just above the lateral epicondyle. We flex the thumb 90 degrees so that the thumbnail now faces forwards. A reserve of skin is given upwards and pressure is applied on the anterior aspect of humerus. The active phase of the deep friction is an arm movement downwards with pressure in a posterior direction, followed, as always, by a phase of relaxation. Starting position is 3/4 of extension and pronation. We have to check two localizations: the tendon level with the joint line, or level with the radial head. The thumb is put as flat as possible on the lesion. The reserve of skin is taken in a medial direction. Pressure is applied, and the active phase of the deep friction is a movement in a lateral direction. Make sure you perform arc movement instead of a bigger movement. The starting position is 90 degrees flexion and supination. Level with the neck of the radius, the pinching grip with all fingers is used. We pinch the muscle belly. The therapist stands at the posterior aspect of the patient, the proximal foot at the height of the patient's shoulder. Always check the range of extension first. 180 degrees is a minimum range required. The patient's shoulder is in medial rotation. Three elements have to be built in: maximal wrist flexion, the therapist's thumb between the thumb and index finger of the patient, maximal elbow extension, and finally step sideways behind the patient's back in order to increase the tension. These elements have to be coordinated, and the manipulation itself then becomes a combination of these three elements. We keep the elbow in complete extension. We find the medial epicondyle and proceed to the front of it. At the teneperiostal junction, deep friction is a straight line movement and the feel is rather hard. At the musculotendinous junction, about 1 centimeter more distally, the deep friction is a more ample round movement and the feel is softer.
Okay, yang tu cakap videonya, Cik Riza?
Ya, betul. So, kalau awak tengok dekat dalam elbow tadi tu, ada few techniques kan. Basically, kita boleh classifikan tennis elbow tu, dia ada 4 type. Type 1, type 2, type 3 and then type 4. So, it depend on dekat mana dia punya lesion tu. And then, satu lagi tadi tu, last tu awak dah tengok Mills manipulation. Kan? Okay, so pernah tahu, pernah belajar ke pasal manipulation? So basically kan macam tadi dikata kalau ada chronic lesion, you boleh combinekan juga dengan manipulation. So untuk elbows, sort of dia punya manipulation is that Mills manipulation. Okay, okay, buka my thank you slide itu and then we are open for, ada berapa minit lagi ni untuk Q&A? Ataupun kalau tak ada, then it's okay lah. That's all daripada saya. Hopefully you all gain some knowledge, ataupun if you this knowledge ya baru you dah tahu sebelum ni, then please refresh your knowledge lah. Is it something new untuk you all semua ataupun macam mana?
New.
Okay, good. So hopefully bagi Jumaat yang barakah ni, you dapat satu ilmu yang baru, insyaAllah.
Sekejap ya Encik Izam. Ada siapa-siapa lagi yang nak tanya soalan ke, boleh usulkan dekat chat box kita. Belum Encik Izam akhiri sesi dia. Cik Sarah ke Cik Zahidah. Cik Syamirah ada soalan?
Dah puas tanya sepanjang session tadi, tengah-tengah jalan.
Dan sebab itu saya nak ambil peluang untuk ucapkan selamat datang kepada Dr. Isna, Ida Hasni dan juga Encik Saiful Adni. Selamat datang. Ya, jadi masalah. Kalau tak ada apa, kita akhiri sesi kita kat sini. Encik Rizam, terima kasih banyak-banyak atas ilmu yang diberikan.
Terima kasih kepada atas sudi jumpa saya. Thank you kepada Aizie yang dia yang recommend. And thank you Dr. Ida ni juga Yusri, okay, sama-sama tuan. Dan lain lagi ada sudut semua pada saya. Semoga semoga dapat pendapatan dan all the best. Okay, thank you. And then we have a few
sekali lagi terima kasih Encik Rizam atas kesedihan Encik Rizam meluangkan masa untuk program kita hari ini. InsyaAllah kalau ada rezeki kita bersua lagi. InsyaAllah.